Recommendation 5 of the What Works Clearinghouse Practice Guide, Assisting Students Struggling with Mathematics Intervention in the Elementary Grades, is to provide deliberate instruction on word problems to deepen mathematical understanding and to support students' capacity to apply mathematical ideas. The What Works Clearinghouse and Expert Panel assigned a strong level of evidence to this recommendation. This means that there is consistent evidence that meets What Works Clearinghouse standards and that the practice improves outcomes for a diverse student population. The practice guide outlines 5 action steps teachers should use to carry out this recommendation. The first step is to teach students to identify word problem types that include the same action or event. The teacher introduces each problem type one at a time and introduces each new problem type with a story that includes all the quantities, so there's no missing information for the student to find. This helps students think about what the problem type event means and what the quantities mean. And next, the student presents a word problem. This time, the story is the same, but there's a missing number. As the teacher and students discuss the problem type with the story and with the word problem, the teacher uses role-playing, gestures, and concrete or semi-concrete manipulatives to help students visualize how the quantities relate to each other and what the mathematics event means. The teacher shows students other examples of the problem type using different scenarios and numbers, so they see how the problem type stays the same, even as scenarios and quantities change. After the teacher helps students understand the problem type, the second action step is to teach students a solution method for solving that problem type. Solution methods can include graphic organizers, diagrams, tables, or equations that link to the problem type by connecting to and representing the problem type's key underlying mathematics event. The teacher introduces the solution method using a worked out example. As the teacher applies the solution method, she explains why each step makes sense, and gradually students take responsibility for explaining and completing those steps. The third action step is to gradually expand the student's ability to identify the problem type by varying the way information is presented. Once students recognize and solve the most accessible problems within a problem type, the teacher presents word problems of that same type, but in ways that broaden student understanding of the problem type. In the panel's opinion, it is essential that teachers include problems that vary the kind of unknown quantity to help students understand the problem type's mathematical structure. The fourth action step is for the teacher to teach the vocabulary and language constructions often used in that word problem type. She teaches the vocabulary and language constructions as she introduces each new problem type, as she teaches its solution strategy, and as she expands the student's understanding of that problem type. And the fifth action step is to provide systematic review that mixes new and previously taught word problem types as the teacher teaches each problem type.